Hey, how you doing? Anthony Ferraro here at Create Sci-Fi. Today we're in the office at the desk, so that means work, roll your sleeves up kind of work. We're not making props, we're not making costumes. We have to create our playground to use the props and costumes. Today I want to talk about screenwriting again, and more specifically, not screenwriting, but I want to talk about storytelling, filmmaking. As DIY filmmakers, the tendency is to have an idea for something that we're compelled to make. And because in the beginning we're kind of on our own and only have friends, you kind of have to do everything yourself, right? And I think one big problem that I had early on was that as a storyteller, I've always had a vivid sci-fi fantasy imagination. But I spent a lot of time learning the craft of acting, learning the craft of directing and producing. I didn't spend a lot of time learning screenwriting. And I suffered for that because all my energy, all my effort would be really interesting characters. I'd have great scenes, but as a film, as a presentation, I always fell short. And it wasn't until I started looking at structure that I began to address that. And you know, every time I make a film now, I'm getting better at that. I'm always trying. That's going to be a lifelong pursuit. So what I wanted to share with you today is storytelling, filmmaking, but not screenwriting, what you need to do in order to make your short film and make it interesting for an audience, right? Rather than just you exercising these creative demons from your head of something that you needed to see, right? So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm starting a new project, right? Right now it's called Project Manager. And also, as far as momentum budget, low budget, what I do on this channel, what I preach and what I practice is that. So now I'm going to start talking about this film I want to make. I'm going to make a video for you about the script, the story, and then the process of making it. And then it's twofold. For you, it's going to show you the process, but for me, it compels me to finish this because it's hard to do this with no money, right? So the first thing is the story idea, and you have to have a script to share that with people you need to get involved to make this. And like I said, so the story I have this idea. It's two female characters. It's post-apocalypse. There's some sort of alien invasion. And I know I want it to take place in like a wooded area. And then they're going to take a little journey and they're going to end up on a beach. These are the things that I know about that. And, you know, many, many years ago, I would just start to develop the characters and the dialogue. But you need to have a journey that the audience can follow, right? So the most effective thing that I found and the easiest thing that I found is Dan Harmon, way back before he was well known for Community and Rick and Morty, had a channel called 101 where it was for filmmakers to share their work, right? And he has this amazing post, story structure 101, super basic stuff, right? And what I really like about this is you can read a lot of books about screenplay writing, you can take classes, and lots of times it's with people that have great information and it's very helpful, but it's hard to figure out who these people are, right? What I love about this is Dan Harmon just shared this before he was well known, because he's passionate about storytelling, right? And he, I imagine, was compelled to say, look, I think this works and it can help you. And then he went on to make Community and Rick and Morty, right? So the proof is in the pudding. And now this is based on the hero's journey, right? So there's a deep tradition here. Joseph Campbell's The Hero's Journey, which is, you know, where Star Wars comes from. And that's a very involved system that's definitely worth learning about, and you should check that out. But this is digestible, right? This is doable. He's sort of boiled it down and given us the essence of it, and it's something that works. And when you learn this, you'll notice that the Rick and Morty episodes are very much like this, right? They're in the garage. They're presented with sort of an adventure. They go on that adventure. They learn some things. They bring it back, and you know, they evolved or evolve humorously for us, right? So Hero's Journey, I started applying that to my early work, but it's a lot of work, and it's very deep, right? So because this is based on it and it's simplified, I find this very effective. So I've shared with you before my system of free writing, right? So whenever I have that idea, what I'll do is I'll begin free writing and I'll just start riffing on the idea. And I'll just start, you know, just writing whatever comes to mind about this story that I have. And the key to get the train moving out of the station is you can't be overwhelmed with trying to create this masterpiece. You just want to get the story out of your head, right? So what I'll do is I'll take Dan Harmon's structure that he shares, and I'm going to send links to this. Now, what I don't want to do is take his ideas, what he shares, and then present it as my own, right? So I'm not providing you with downloads. I'm not reinterpreting his words into my own. I'm just evangelizing. I'm just sharing with you something that works, right? Best idea wins. I had some ideas, they weren't the best ideas. His are, so we're gonna go from his. So I'll certainly link to his work so you could check that out, right? So that's why I'm not gonna dive into it too deep, because it's not mine, right? So I'm just sharing with you something that works, and then we're going to incorporate that, fold that into our work, right? Does that make sense? So, you know, you're gonna review this material, and then at the basis of it, the hero's journey, depending what you read, is like 12 steps, right? The call to action, the trials and tribulations, the belly of the whale, all these things, and that makes sense to you if you've read it, or when you do read it, it'll make sense to you. But he breaks it down very simply, just who's the person, what's your need, where you're going, what are you searching for, what did you find, what do you take from that, your return, and how did you change, right? Sounds really simple, but it needs to be that simple at the core of it, right? So what I'll do is, you know, I've shared with you my free writing exercises where, you know, I just write the script from my head. But to keep it on track and to have a structure to my story, what I'll do is, before the free writing, is I'll answer those questions very, very basically, right? And for me, like in this one, you is my character June and my character Valerie. She says, oh, I was a bartender. The other one says, oh, I worked in video game development. That changes, but that's where I started, right? Need, what was the need? Well, there's an invasion, so they needed to get safe. They needed to get shelter. And then, you know, I leave gaps here because that's where I'm gonna fill out. Then the go, they're like, all right, we gotta make an effort to make our lives better. So they go, so now I know they're on their journey. So they search. All right, so they meet somebody who presents them with something that can help them, but to have this thing help them, they have to find this other person. So now they're searching, right? So then they find this other person who solves one of their problems, but also presents them with, okay, well, now you have to take what I'm sharing with you and bring it back to these people. So now they got to return to where they started, having learned something on this journey, right? And then the end is, okay, is a new beginning, or it's the end and it's wrapping this up, right? And I purposely want that to sound super simple, because it is. So now I just go in and I fill in these gaps and I start telling my story, right? Then I have a version one. I come back the next day, I start cleaning up, I have a version two. One thing that I tend to do is I'm a horrible speller, and I just blow through this because I don't want to stop. And once I start correcting spelling, right, that's another pass. So then now I basically have this short story. It has the journey, it has all the cues. And it's always refining, right? I think a lot of things that a lot of people get overwhelmed because they're trying sentence by sentence, moment by moment, to write this perfect thing. And it doesn't work that way. Even when you've worked on it for a year and you're done, somebody's going to come back to you that holds the keys and saying, well, we're going to make it, but we need to change this thing. And you're going to, it's always changing, right? So you should think of it as a process rather than being bogged down with, of course you want it to be good, you want it to be the best, but you need to be taking a ride in the process, right? So then once I have that story, then I'll go in to a screenwriting program and I'll start copying and pasting. And then once I'm copying this dialogue into my document, then it's another pass where I'm seeing it a different way and I start thinking, oh, okay, they need to say this for this to make sense. But I still have that spine that I created early on, right? Because that stuff gets stuck in your head. So back to my original point in all this is that a lot of us get into acting, we get into filmmaking, we get into art, we get into all these aspects that make us of the process that make us want to create our own film, right? So let's say you're good at directing, you have an idea of acting, and you can produce, you can get people together. But maybe writing you've not spent a lot of time on, but you're gonna make the short film. Make sure you follow this structure. Just do it. And again, like I said, I'm going to share this 101 and I really think you should take a look at it. And I'm being very careful to be clear to you that I'm evangelizing this, right? That I'm saying like, this is a really great tool. This is not mine. I'm not regurgitating this and calling it my own. I'm saying this person shared something pretty great. He also went on to prove himself, right? So I think this is a very valuable tool and I can't really improve on it. But what I can do is share with you how I use it and how it gets me to the next level. And now, again, broken record, we're talking about my next script now. Working title, project manager. I'm sure that's gonna change. But now I have this script. And stay tuned for the next step. And really what I want to just hit home for you is that when you're sitting down to do your next project, just make sure that you have a structure for the audience. The character, the situation, that's uniquely yours and that's your own voice. But that structure, you really want to tie into the subconscious of the world that we live in and tell them a story within that framework. You'll be glad that you did. All right. It's a little talky-talky this video, but hopefully you found this useful. Please like, share, subscribe, leave a comment. I love to read the comments. And be sure to check out our merch store. We got the Create Sci-Fi t-shirts. Those really help the channel. And remember, I'm just here to help make sci-fi.